So when we started the morning, we planned on hopefully getting some fish. And at the end of the day, once you do have your fish and you're ready to go home, it's always a good idea to get your eggs on cure before you leave. The nice thing is when they're still fresh, they'll take the cure a lot better. They'll color up a lot better. So to get that going, basically, once you land your fish, if it's a hen, it's a good idea to always bleed it out. As you can see, we bled it out, and there's a majority of the blood is out of them, which is a good thing. You don't want too much blood in them. And once you got your skein, what I generally will do is run a knife or a pair of scissors down the inside of the exposed portion, so it's more or less butterflying the skein open. And then once they're butterflied open to where they're nice and exposed and all the embryos on the backside that's still intact, what I'll do is I'll take it and I'll cut them into thirds. So there's those right there. It seems to help take the cure a little bit better. And the cure I'm going to use today is the Fuze in the Steelhead blend. We're in steelhead season right now. We still got a little bit of the season left, so I want to get some good fresh eggs. So I'm just going to stick with that one. And basically what I'll try to do is, I'm going to try not to make a mess out of Rich's boat. So I'll just do them a couple skeins at a time, or a couple of chunks at a time. Put them in here. And then I usually use the sprinkle side. Put that in there and put a fair amount in there, but don't go overboard with it. Roll them around a little bit. The steelhead cure does not have any sulfites in it, so you don't have to worry about burning the egg. So if you go a little more cure than not enough, it's not a bad thing. When it gets in contact with the eggs, it's going to be kind of powdery for a little bit, but it juices up really good and it'll absorb into the eggs for sure. Once you got that, you got that cure in there, just zip them up and let them sit until you get home, and then put them in a more open container and spread them out a little bit more, and then just keep letting them juice up for a couple days. And once they absorb all they're going to absorb and that curing process is done, just lay them out, get all the juice off of them, let them air dry, and then stick them in a container and pour some plain white borax on them and freeze them up, and you're ready to go. We're going to do a couple different batches because it's always good to have an assortment of egg cures and different eggs when you're on the boat fishing. So this one, again, we did the same process. We butterflied the skeins open, cut them into thirds. And then with these, what we're going to do is we're going to do them in the liquid egg cure. This is the red hot color. We do it in a pink and an orange as well. And this one's a lot easier, less messy. So basically just take your skeins, put them in the quart jar. Shake up the cure real good. Take it. Pour it in there just till the eggs are all saturated and it's covering them. Like that. Take a lid of the quart jar and put it on there. And what you're going to do is you're going to let that sit in there, depending on if you want a wet egg or a drier egg is the amount of time, cure time you'll give them. But generally with the liquid egg cure, I personally like to go about 10 to 11 hours and then let them sit in there until that cure is nice and absorbed into the eggs. You'll almost see this, how much fluid there is in there now. By the time they're all cured up, that'll all be gone. And these eggs will be a brilliant, nice, bright red color. What's a good idea too is when you're about halfway through, or about every 2 to 3 hours, is take that quart jar and flip it over. Because just like in the jar, some of the powders will settle to the bottom. So it's a good idea to flip them over. That way it keeps those chemicals spread throughout the eggs. So 2 or 3 hours, flip them back over. And eventually that juice will all be gone. It'll be just absorbed into the eggs. And what's a good idea too, after it's all absorbed in there for 10 to 12 hours, take them out of that cure, let them out, and let them air dry until they're nice and tacky. And then once you're done with our quart jars, we have a container on here. You can label what they are. So species, whatever you might be targeting, location, wherever you got them. The cure used, you can put on there, and the date cured. that's kind of a neat feature to have. That way you know what cure you got on there. So.